Okay, and it's actually recording this time. All right, so hi, I'm Towns Osborne Miller, and I'm with my student, Caitlin Richard. She's a senior. She's in her last semester of lessons, and will be doing her student teaching in the fall. So we were talking about hand position. As you can see, Caitlin has a little wrap on her wrist, and so that kind of came into question about hand position and exercises we can do to make some corrections in how we hold and play the flute. So that's what we're dealing with right now, and then we'll move on to the Doppler Hungarian Pastoral Fantasy. Okay, thanks. All right, so we talked about swinging our arm, right? So when you go to teach, right, you're gonna, and then this is your natural hand position, and anything that deviates from that, probably not good, okay? So when we talked about how you were playing, we were talking about how you tend to like to rest the backs of your fingers against the rod and keep your pinky straight. And what we're addressing right now is the concept of moving from that tendency to a more ergonomically correct or a better way to play, okay? But it does take time. Takes time, okay? So the one exercise is you start by swinging your arm back and forth, bringing the hand up, and then practicing in front of a mirror with the lightest touch possible. Lightest touch, no gorilla grip. Okay, lightest touch possible. Squeezing here is not going to make it better. Okay, it's an actual location of the pinky. So play what you think is B. Yeah, you just have a slight little leak in the foot, okay, which is causing you to want to squeeze. Try to get there again. I'm going to roll this up just a little bit so I can see the wrist, okay? Start on low D. Yeah, that's not you. Because when I add my fingers, it works. That makes sense? Mm-hmm. Try it again. Start on. So it's D, E flat, D, D flat, D, C, D, B.
Okay.
But you gotta be there. You're like doing something. So go in between the two. So D. And then the one last rotation I'm going to make, Caitlin. Yes, how'd you know? If I I'm here playing and you're here playing, there's something wrong. Because now I want you to feel my tendons, okay? So put a hand on my tendons there. All right, so if this is the flute, I'm gonna come around the other side, sorry. If this is the flute and I'm playing, do that.
Okay,
you feel that?
Mm-hmm.
You feel that? You feel the difference?
Mm-hmm.
It's a whole different stress load on those tendons. So, you need to practice everything slowly and be intentional about the process. Okay? It's the unintentional practice. When we're just trying to get through it, that's when we end up injured. Okay, it's when it's unintentional. No one sets out to go, I think I'm gonna injure myself today. Right? No one sets out to do that. I hope you don't. So it's an unintentional injury, but it comes from not being intentional about the process. Makes sense, doesn't it? So for the rest of this month, even if it means you play everything down tempo, you need to be intentional about the process, right? So when you go to play scales, you're intentional, right? I want you working on Tafanel and Gobert, but slowly, in front of a mirror, I mean, because the pattern same is the same for a whole phrase, right? So in front of a mirror, you're gonna practice and you're gonna be intentional. You're not gonna lift your fingers to the sky. You're not gonna have a gorilla grip. It's going to be intentional to relax, to make sure you've got the rotation and the shoulders not up around the ear and we're not here, okay? That all comes from unintentional, but you have to be intentional. So do you see how my fingers are barely moving, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? And my pinky stays curved and it's intentional. And they're harder finger passages than others. So some are gonna require that you have to go even slower. Some, like the opening one, there's always an issue between E and F sharp. Because this finger will want to move first, but it needs to move second. You've got to lead with your index finger, okay? So you get the gross exaggeration. You hear it? Because that's F sharp, and this is F sharp. This is the better F sharp. This is the flute F sharp. Saxophone F sharp, flute F sharp, okay? So you need to lead with your index finger to help avoid that that glitch. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So you pay attention to those things at the slower tempo. But regardless, my pressure is even and it's light. So if you can't play light with your flute, then there's an issue with the flute, not with the player. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
The number one issue you have with high school band students and middle school band students and junior high band students with flute players when you go to teach next semester, it's not the player. 9 times out of 10, it's the instrument. And if the instrument doesn't work, I've gone to schools where I listen to a kid play and I'm like, oh wow. And they're all contorted and they've got, and I go and I try and I think, hey, maybe I'll just try your flute. And I'll play a little something on my flute first so they can hear what a working flute sounds like, right? And I'll play the exact same thing on their flute, and they're gonna go, whoa, sorry. We don't move, evidently we don't move around enough, so the lights click off. But my point is that they always go, whoa. And then I'm like, yeah, it's not you. So they're squeezing, and they're contorting, and they're doing all these crazy things, but it's not them, it's the instrument that's broken. I'm not suggesting that your instrument is broken. I'm just suggesting that you practice a lot And it's like anything. It's like driving a car. The more miles you put on it, the more routinely you're going to need to oil change, rotate the tires, you know, change the belts, you know, after a certain amount of time. It's going to happen faster because you're driving more often. So those things are going to happen more often, okay? So the more you practice, the more your flute is going to need service because you're giving it a better workout on a day-in, day-out basis as opposed to the person that just picks it up on occasion. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? All right, let's do a little bit of Doppler, please. And I'm going to turn back on the lights while you get that set up. Experiment with using vibrato, but also staying soft.
Okay.
Okay. Two. Now, what's written there is this. You've got hairpins, right? So you have to have a clear direction, and it's not like a piano to a forte. It's a piano maybe to a mezzo piano or a mezzo forte. It's an expression, right? That's all that is. And remember, you're a gypsy, right? Make sure you articulate a ta on that, please. And I'd probably see a lot better if I had my glasses. All right. Did that feel different to you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it.
Let's do it again. Continue to work on it. Keep working on the speed.
Okay.
But I heard every single note, and that's excellent. Excellent. Okay? Good. Let's just do that whole opening again. A little less of me, more of you.
Okay.
Okay? of breathing.
Okay.
Okay? And we have got to address articulations.
Okay.
Because you're not always doing it. Okay? So, now, I am going to bring out the articulations. I don't want you to pounce on them like you're getting ready to hear, but I just want to drive home what it is that we're after, okay?
Okay.
So. Oh, look, I can see the notes a lot better. Here and here, because even though they're a connected run, it's the idea of this phrase. Okay, and then, so yeah, so do you see, you just have to be very clear. You can't just choose not to. And do you hear what I'm doing effect-wise here? So if I go, you're not looking for ta ta ya ta ta. We're not looking for that, okay? But you have to know where you're articulating, and it can't be. The composer went to a lot of trouble to write in the articulations that he wanted.
Okay.
So it's your due diligence and responsibility to communicate that, okay? And even if it's more of a da articulation as opposed to a ta articulation, that is almost a judgment call, right? I mean, obviously, this is gypsy. So you know, you don't want to be in the listener's face, like, listen to me articulate, ha ha ha. But by the same token, it's the articulation that helps give the shape to the phrase, right? So you got to pay attention to it, okay? The consequences of what you did were these motives went too slow, okay, and so did these, right? So, questions?
No. Problem.
Okay, great. So continue to work on articulations there, okay? And overall gypsy feeling. Oh, that was the other thing. When you were articulating and paying attention to that, your whole frame kind of went
yep.
You felt it, didn't you? You were kind of like,
yep,
all over here. So let the music speak for itself. You can do that.
Okay.
Just gotta combine the two. Practice in front of the mirror. Video record yourself. Okay. So you can actually see what your tendencies are. You can see your bad habits and go, oh, ho, ho, ho. I get what Dr. Miller is talking about. Make sense?
Yep.
Will you do that?
Yep.
Okay. Are you going to share with me some of the recordings? You can. Miracle of modern technology. Just a little clip. And I want the clip to be when you got it right. So send me a clip. Hey, Dr. Miller, it's Wednesday, and I got it right. Watch. Because identifying when you get it right versus when you get it wrong is equally as important as the opposite. Oh, I'm looking forward to getting a text message with a video attached, okay? All right, poco animato. So it needs to go a little bit faster, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, more with animation. You're gonna be playful. You're like cat and mouse.
Okay.
But soft doesn't mean a vibrato. You can do vibrato and play soft. Piano plays a chord and with you, and then you have time to breathe because the piano is just sustaining, if I remember correctly, just sustaining that chord.
Yep.
Yep. And you do your thing. So you can kind of do an accelerando and then a rallentando into the fermata. Okay?
Okay.
So ti di da di da ga da da di 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 ga da da. And then you have your solo. Good. So the feel here, I like it like that.
Okay.
Okay. So you have. dum 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 right? And then same feel here.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's just do the Pocono Monto section again. Here we go. So can we go ba da ba da da di da 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 di da da. Take control the reins there. Yeah, a little, but that was better here with the mezzo forte to piano. It can still be a little bit more contrasting.
Okay.
Yeah, right here. Start on the pickup because the E is inconsequential and it's making you not breathe where you have scheduled a breath. So just start with the dee da dee da da. You just did, everyone will hear it as ah. You need vibrato, and it's like way more. And plus, what's the dynamic? Yeah, and where do you need to aim your ear?
Down.
Mm-hmm. And engage the entire body. Okay. Make sure you get the right notes there. It's dee da dee da dee da dum. Right there. Articulate. All right. you're going to tongue the A.
Yep.
And the E. And the C sharp. The F and the C sharp. And the E. The F. C sharp. D.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Just take it from the E flat. Just on the E flat. Yeah, sorry.
Okay.
I meant E natural.
It's okay.
But it's gotta make sense. So if you're gonna go be da da da, then it's gotta be ba da 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 da. Not be da 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 da. That doesn't relate. Does that make you know what I mean? Right? Okay. Yeah. Did I hang out on that C sharp a long time?
No.
No. So it's a gesture. It's just an articulation. It's so I gotta let you go, but practice singing that. You don't just sing it in the octave that was written, that'd be impossible, right? But because if you can't sing what it is you're wanting to do, chances are you can't play it. If you can't communicate verbally what it is through song, and even if it's da da di da di da da di da di da da, if you're going da da di da di da da, that you like physically know, it's a visceral reaction. You know that doesn't make sense, right? To sing it that way. So practice singing, even if it's da 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 da, whatever. Okay, practice singing it, because if you can't sing what you're wanting to do, you're not gonna be able to play it. Doesn't matter how many times you put the flute up to your mouth. All right,
okay.
So you know the notes.
So you're going for like a taxi feel on those?
Yeah, elephant.
Okay.
Da 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 da, elephant, and catch the elephant.
Okay.
Right? No one goes, elephant! On that happy note, we're going to end your lesson.